Good morning, class. I hope you all are doing well and taking care of yourself and your family. So, in last video, I had asked you to show me your talent, and I got many of you had given your what we say your hobbies, and I liked it. You all have so much of talent, and please keep it up. Keep it up for your talent you have. See, studies is a part of our life, but our talent is also our part of life only, or maybe our life that is going to give you in future your business, your happiness, most important thing. So your passion is your happiness, and the thing you love to do is your passion, right? So there are artists, maximum artists are there. There are cooks also we have. Right, then I had got message from one of the students. He loves to do what we say cubics and all that. So this is one thing that I had seen first time, and for that I would like to say all of you are very good in your work, and please I want more initiative from all of the students. Like, I want to know how much talented my kids are. That you all are like a rough diamond, and if you polish yourself, see, we will help you, but you have to polish yourself. Everyone has a talent, and the talent is to be recognized by you. And don't think there would be one of my student was like of last year's. He was what we say beatbox or something he was doing, and he was very good in his work. Dancers were there, fashion designers were there. One of my our student was an interior designer. He used to make what you say them small sample flats and all that are prepared through wood and all that, miniature flats, miniature demos and all that. So that this much of creativity I had seen in the students. And yes, you all are creative. That's not, you are not creative, but there would be more creation. I hope so. All of you are very good. Some of them have sent their paintings through pastels also. Shaded pen painting. So I liked it and I loved it. Everyone is very good in their own criteria, right? And try to improve more. It is for everyone. If you are good, go for better. If you are better, go for the best. And if you are best, then also try to find out a new kind of thing. So the moral of the story is that don't stop yourself. Encourage yourself to do something that you love to do. Maybe you will find a future in that, right? And studies are also important. So focus on studies also. Otherwise, your parents will kill me. The teacher is teaching them wrong thing. But I don't think that is wrong to have passion or a talent other than studies. So I am that kind of person that want to appreciate it and really want to appreciate the student, those who are having extra talent. I had not that best out of waste. I would like to see that. I would like to see some of you as a fashion designer. I would like to see some of you as an interior designer. More creativity, whatever, something like that. Cubics were, one was there. So let us hope I get more answers from many of you. And I'm waiting for your answers. Like, teacher, we like to do this, and I'm happy we are interacting, because I'm not asking. I cannot ask in the group. I can ask over here only. This is our personal interaction, and I'm loving to get interaction from you. So best of luck for your other things. Now coming to that, our topic. What is our topic? Precautions to be taken to recognize types of accounts. Now we had seen what is personal account, what are included in personal account, what are included in nominal account, what are included in real account. Now in that also there are certain categories that needs to be taken care. Remember I had used the word outstanding. Outstanding income, outstanding expense, that are different. And because of the expenses, when salary is there, it becomes an expense. But when it's an outstanding expense, it becomes a liability for the person. So the pattern of account changes. When it is a salary, it goes as an expense. So it goes to nominal account. Is it clear? But when the word outstanding salary is used to it, it goes to personal account. When outstanding word is attached with any of the income or expense, it goes to personal account, right? Is it clear? Outstanding would be outstanding expense yet to be paid, and outstanding would be for yet to be received, that is receivables. Is it clear? So let us see that in detail. Take example. both salary and outstanding salary separate accounts are applicable. For salary, income expenditure account, that is expense account, is applicable. And for outstanding salary, that is account, personal account is applicable. Let us see through an example. See over here. Don't get confused. Take your time. Listen to this videos 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, 10 times. Until and unless you are not clear what is it. Because this is the thing, I hope. The very plus point of these videos are that whenever you get confused, you can click to the videos of the particular date and particular related topic, and you can again listen to our videos, and it will be helpful to you. Right, in class it was not helpful. We were giving you present lectures, but what was said, that was gone. Right? Here you have a plus point, the most important positive point. If you forget anything, you can again take out this video and check it out right or wrong. So if you think, teacher, I don't remember on this day this video was there. Suppose you are seeing this transaction. So this video will be published to you on your channel. It will be coming on 30th of July. So you can write on this textbook, this topic is delivered on 30th of July 2020. So whenever you are not getting idea about this topic, you can easily find out the video of the date accounts 30th July 2020. So that will help you. Is it clear? It's a tip also for remembering when, if you are not going for understanding what the teacher has said, or now you are understanding when you are applying it in the sums and you are not able to understand, go through these videos, right? And you can personally ask me also, right? So transaction in reference to expenses and types of account. See, here 3 things are there. Pay attention over here. See, when it is a salary, it's an expense. Right, so it becomes nominal account. Is it clear? So when it is only salary, it becomes expense, and expense is a nominal account. When it is a salary outstanding yani baki hai, so it is outstanding, we will pay it in future, so it becomes personal account because it is a liability. What? Because it is a liability of the business, means you have to pay in future, so that's why it becomes when salary is outstanding, so it becomes liability. In the same way, when it is paid in advance, it becomes receivable. Receivable means you can say it as asset. When it is paid in advance, many times what happens, when our employees are there, they will take advance from us. So that is termed as, in accounting terms, as paid in advance. Is it clear? So in short, it's an asset. Is it clear? Let it be. So salary paid in advance. It is asset. So it is treated as asset. So it goes to the asset side. That's why I had written it in asset in this side. Is it clear? So salary has three words in it. First, a common name, that is salary. When it is a salary, it's an expense for the business. We have to pay for the employee. So salary, when it is an expense, it is a nominal account. When it is outstanding, salary outstanding means yet to be paid. So it becomes a liability. That is, you are going to write on liability side, balance sheet, that you will learn in part 2 book, right? But when you had paid in advance, so it becomes an asset. So it goes to receivables, because you had paid in advance. So you will receive the service of that person in future. That's why it is said as asset, or it is a receivables. Is it clear? In the same way, you can see rent paid. Rent paid again an expense. Expense goes to nominal account. Let's see over here. Nominal accounts. Why? Because it is an expense. When rent is outstanding, means when expense is outstanding, it goes to personal account. By personal account, the reason is it is converted into liability. Right, so it is a liability. Right, so rent paid in advance. What is rent paid in advance? Rent paid in advance is your asset. Means you had paid in advance and you are going to use that product or that particular place in future. So it becomes your asset. Is it clear? So again, it's a receivable, but it will be recorded on asset side. Is it clear? I hope you all are getting this. It's a very simple concept. So it's an asset, right? So rent paid, expense that goes to nominal account. Rent outstanding means expense outstanding, though, that goes to personal account, and it is treated as liability. Then rent paid in advance that goes to personal account, but it is treated as asset. In the same way, commission. Commission, when it is an expense, that is commission paid. So it goes to expense. So nominal account, you can see over here. Commission outstanding. So commission outstanding goes to personal account. It's a liability. In short, all the expenses that are paid goes to nominal account. All the expenses that are outstanding, that goes to liability. All the expenses that are paid in advance, that goes to receivables. And they are asset. And the outstanding and paid in advance are treated as personal account. Is it clear? So you can see in the commission also. Brokerage is again same, brokerage paid. So nominal account, it's an expense. Brokerage means whenever you do a deal between two persons, and in that you are dealing in between as them meeting, bringing them together, buyer and supplier. So they will pay you certain amount that is termed as brokerage, same as commission. In textile industry, it is famous. The brokerage, when it is an expense, it is nominal account. When it is outstanding, yani yet to be received, it is a personal account and it becomes a liability. But when it is paid in advance and personal account, it is a receivable, again asset. So some transaction of business can be expense and income, rent paid, rent received, commission paid, commission received, brokerage paid, brokerage received, discount allowed, discount received, etc. Illustration for this. Now related to income. That was related to expense. Right, so these are related to income. That upper one was related to types of account of expense. When commission is received, so this is your income and it goes to nominal account and it is your income, right? When commission is outstanding, it goes to personal account because it is your receivables. Receivables means you are going to receive it that you are going to receive it so here it becomes your asset. Right, so when it is your income is outstanding, yani yet to be received, any form of income. You can see over here, it is commission, it is brokerage, it is dividend, it is rent received, anything that is treated as receivables and it becomes an asset. In the same way, when commission received in advance is there, so it becomes a liability because you had received the amount and you need to do the give the service related to it in future, so it becomes a liability. Is it clear? So it becomes a liability and it is written again on liability side. Right. So I hope you all are clear. What does this want to say to you? Right, so it becomes a liability. So again, I'm repeating it, commission received. When it's an income, it's a nominal amount. But commission, when it is yet to be received or outstanding commission, that goes to personal account and it is treated as asset, yeah, that is receivables. But when commission received in advance is there, it again goes to personal account and it is treated as liability. I had explained you in the same. In the same way, here you can see brokerage received. Brokerage is what? Brokerage is also again a new form of income. So when it's an income received is there, so nominal account. But when brokerage outstanding is there, it goes to personal account and it becomes receivables. But brokerage received in advance is there, then it becomes liability. So this is asset and this is liability. When it is receivable, it becomes asset. But when it is paid in advance, not received in advance, so it becomes liability. In the same way, dividend received. Dividend means when we are investing in shares and the share company, the company in which we had invested, they pay a certain amount. Like interest, it is termed as dividend. But in accounting terms, for the share companies, they term as dividend. So dividend is what? Our income. So when dividend is received, it's a nominal account. But when dividend is outstanding, it goes to asset side. That is, personal account is converted into personal account and it becomes receivable. That is, received in future. We are going to receive in future and it becomes your asset. Right? In the same way, when dividend received in advance, if you are receiving in advance, so that is your, again, a personal account, but it goes to liability side. Then rent received again is your income, so it goes to nominal account, but rent yet to be received, so it goes to personal account, it is receivable. Rent received in advance, personal account, it's a liability. Right? So here you have to go through this. These are IMP points. I'm highlighting them. They are again IMP points. So go through them thoroughly. Don't neglect them. Right? So I had given you stars, so you had to go through this. I hope you all are clear. Upper one is also important. So, rules of debit and credit of accounts. Rules of debit and credit of accounts. So, homework for the next video is you will go through these rules and give it to me in written form so I can notice who has done this and who has not done this. So the moral of the story is I want this chart prepared by you in rough book, not in what we say. Okay, we have completed the exercise up till the illustration. So this is to be written by you, rules of accounts in your book. Then only I'm going to explain. And let me, my laptop is not working properly today. Give you this. Okay, this is your homework. Writing CW five times each rule. Is it clear? Means how you are going to write personal account, debit the receiver, credit the giver. 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 This way five times. Then real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Debit what real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. In the same way, five times for nominal account. Debit expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gain. Nominal account, debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gain. So totally 15 times, nothing else is your homework. And that chart, no need to write it, let it be. But this is only your homework. So I hope most of you will complete it. This is my request, and is it clear, students? I think you cannot see over here. It's homework, right, in CW five times each. Is it clear? So till then, take care. And I'm waiting for all of your replies. Let us have interaction with each other. And I hope I had given response to maximum of you. If I had not given, so please again just WhatsApp me. So maybe I had not seen any of the message and someone else had seen. So I would like to see it again. And I'm very happy to see all of you responding so positively. Till then, take care. Bye.